1, 2, 3, 4. Welcome back to another episode of Quick Drag. Today we are profiling this week's co-host. She's lived across Canada, she's performed in many cities across Canada, and she's your current Miss Canada Continental. Please welcome Mona Moore. Hi, Mona.
Yes. Hello, Adrienne. It is so nice to see you.
It's so good to see you too. Welcome to the show, and thank you so much for being my co-host today. Today is the profile episode, so let's talk a little bit about you. How would you describe Mona Moore?
Mona Moore is a bubbly, blonde bombshell. She is such a Broadway baby. I love all things musical theater. Just like a powerhouse performer, and I love to look dressed up to the nines and sparkly from head to toe.
And you do it with style. I love it. What would you say is your most memorable moment in drag?
Oh my goodness. I've been so fortunate that I've had many incredible moments in drag, but definitely one of the best is winning Miss Canada Continental. It's just such a big opportunity, and I'm so glad that I had the chance to even compete.
And that's amazing. Huge congratulations, by the way. But I did want to follow up on that because I heard that the Miss Continental pageant set for September in Chicago has actually been canceled due to COVID-19. Is that correct?
Yes. So Miss Canada Continental was an amazing opportunity, and it gave me a platform to travel the country and promote my drag. But unfortunately, with the pandemic, that got canceled, and I haven't been able to really do what I've had planned. So it's a little unfortunate, and I was a little bummed out to know that my reign of being Miss Canada Continental was during this time where I really had no control over the situation, and I couldn't make the best of my reign. So that was very an unfortunate feeling. And then they said that they postponed Nationals, Miss Continental in Chicago, to September 2021. So that was exciting, knowing I have an extra year to prepare. And then I found out that I will remain Miss Canada Continental until I compete at Nationals in 2021. So I get an extra year of being crowned, and I'm so happy and so glad that I can really take this opportunity and run with it once the world is back to normal and we can do what we can, get out into the venues and the bars and the spaces and just bring light to people's day.
You get an extra year to prepare amazing costumes, exciting performances, and now you get to be Miss Canada Continental for 2 years. Has that ever happened before? I don't think so.
I don't think so, and I'm okay with it.
You're a trailblazer.
Exactly.
How important would you say is social media to drag?
Well, nowadays, going through the pandemic, social media is more important than ever. It's our outlet to the rest of the world. It's our connection between friends, family, and loved ones. So I think it's super important. I'm good at social media, and I'm happy with the things that I put out there, but it's a lot of hard work, and it's not my thing, for a lack of a better word. But I do what I can, and I think it's really important that I have a social media following, especially because the world is in such a digital place. But I think that the more work I put into my social media, the less work I get to put into my craft. And that's the one thing I've noticed the most, and that's kind of a little bit unfortunate. So hopefully one day I'll be rich and famous enough that I can have someone run my social media accounts for me.
If it's not your forte, outsource it, right?
Exactly.
If you could design the legacy that you leave behind as a drag artist, what would that be? What would it look like?
Oh, that's a very, very good question. I really want to inspire young people. I want the little voice out there to see me and say, oh my God, that's how I feel inside, and that's what I want to do with my life. Because I would have given anything to be in their shoes when I was little, and to have drag queens and queer people to help get us through and help find ourselves. So that's definitely something that I would like to leave behind. And of course, some like iconic performances, some gorgeous looks, and people, things that people will remember and appreciate.
So now we'll move into what I like to call quick drag. It's also the name of the program, but we're going to ask you some questions and just looking for some off the cuff, first answer that comes to your mind kind of thing.
Sure.
So what would you say is your favorite artist to lip sync to?
Ariana Grande, because she is fierce and fun and it's hard to know all her words, so she just mumbles really, so. Just a mumbler.
Musical theater or pop music?
Pop music.
Interesting. How tall are you in drag?
I wear 3 to 4 inch heels at least, and I'm 6'3", so about 6'6" to 6'8".
Ooh! Excluding yourself, who is the best local drag queen?
Well, I live in Calgary. I just moved here a few months ago. And there's lots of amazing drag queens here. But I would have to say the best drag queen is Lilith Fair.
What is your karaoke go-to song?
I Want to Dance with Somebody.
Yes, I love it.
Yes.
So one final question. What makes Canadian drag so damn good?
There's drag all across Canada, and every city is very different. They have a very different drag community, very different drag styles. Toronto is like a workhorse of a city where you're doing 4 or 5 shows a week, 12 songs a show, where in lots of other cities you're doing 1 song a night, and maybe there's only 2 to 3 bars. So everyone has a very different drag lifestyle, drag community, and we all strive to be the best. And we're just about to get so much even more awesome, because now there's a fire lit under our ass. Knowing that there's an opportunity for Canadians to get onto Drag Race, that will make us step up our and hopefully turn out some amazing drag, and hopefully the community will grow and thrive, and Canada drag will become more mainstream. I think that's super exciting and definitely a good goal and outcome for Drag Race.
I agree 100%. Love it. Well, that's all my questions. So thank you so much, Mona Moore, for spending time with me this week as my special co-host. And now we'll see a performance from Mona Moore. Oh, 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 oh.
Takes his time, I'll go for any time. I'm a fast moving gal who likes him slow. Got no use for fancy driving, wanna see your guy arriving low. I'd be satisfied, electrified to know a guy would take his time. Fair. I always give the air, wouldn't give any Russian gentle a smile. I would go for any singer who would condescend to linger a while. What a lullaby would be supplied to have a guy who takes his time. Time a hasty jump, really spoils a master's touch. I don't like a big commotion, I'm a demon for slow motion, a search. Why should I deny that I would die to know a guy who takes his chance? There isn't any fun in getting something done if you're rushed when you have to make the grade. I can spot an amateur to appreciate a connoisseur in trade. Who will qualify? No alibi.
Thanks for watching Quick Drag. If you enjoyed what you saw, hit the subscribe button over there. Check out our social media links in the description below. And be sure to come back on Saturday for a new episode of Quick Drag with a brand new drag artist co-host.